joining us right now, and I think if you're not following him on Twitter, you need to rectify that immediately because he has the best on the ground coverage there, period. Julio Rosas, Marine meme economist, as he describes himself. Yeah. He's doing an amazing job covering this for Town Hall. And Julio, first off, I appreciate your service to our country. But secondly, you are able to keep just so calm and focused when everything is so insane all around you as you're covering this. You've got some of the best video from all of this. You're there in Seattle. You've been to CHAZ. You've covered it. What do you say to all of like the MSNBCs and the CNNs who say these are peaceful protests and the way, and it's the right wing media that's maligning these peaceful people? You're there. What are you seeing?
Thanks for having me on, Dana. What I can say is that, and this is what I saw in Minneapolis too when I was covering it. During the day, it is typically peaceful. Although in Minneapolis there was also looking going on during the day. But here in Seattle, it was kind of the same thing where it's kind of turned into kind of like a hippie commune a little bit. But what I can say is that at night, that's when things kind of become a little more dangerous, and that's what I've kind of documented in the past few days. And so when the mainstream media, and I've heard about the New York Times story, I haven't read it in full, but based on my initial presumptions, or they're just highlighting it's just, you know, rainbows, sunshines, and unicorns, that's just simply not true. That's not accurate. There was less than 2 days into this new autonomous zone, as it's being called, there was a warlord, essentially.
CHAZ, right?
Ras Simone, like a SoundCloud rapper or something like that. But he was the only one in the area with guns because the police were gone. And so, of course, him and his posse, anything that said goes because he was the one that had firearms. And so and that was just on day two. And then on night three, I encountered this mob that was trying to accuse this young adult, this young man, of stealing a protester's phone.
Video. Yes.
And there was a guy with a baseball bat, and he said, "I'm going to beat your ass."
Oh, yeah.
And he, luckily for him, he was able to get away, and it was discovered that he actually didn't steal the phone in the first place.
Oh my gosh.
But yes, yeah. So you can imagine if they actually beat him up, only for them to discover, oh wait, he didn't actually steal it. So that's what we're kind of seeing right now. There's no clear leadership in the zone. They are trying to figure it out, but because there's so many different types of people there at any given time, they're having a hard time reaching a consensus on what to do next. They're right. Really quickly there's a packet being given out that said they're either gonna hold the zone and like take over the precinct for good, move the zone to another location, or dissolve the zone in order to take more direct action elsewhere, whatever that means.
Right. So the reason that they looked at these six blocks was just because that's where that precinct was located, and that's they just ended up taking that over and then expanding from there. Because this all started, they're protesting police brutality. They want to defund and totally dismantle police. And then the first thing that they do when they set up their autonomous zone, which is questionably autonomous, is they built a wall and got armed patrol and began checking people's IDs and stopping and frisking, basically, correct?
Yeah, so they a funny story about that. So I got here on Tuesday, so a day after the police left, and the Seattle Department of Transportation came by late morning, early afternoon, and they were just going to leave the orange water barriers just to make sure that just designed to block road access, to make sure that no one doesn't drive through, because there was a driver who drove through and shot somebody. And so there were other police barricades. There was like fencing around. So they were going to take away all of that and just leave the orange barriers. Well, the occupiers weren't too happy with that, so they kind of strong-armed them into leaving basically everything. The only thing that the SDOT took was the concrete barriers that were just on the sidewalk. So they weren't really doing much of anything.
Right.
They're just on the sidewalk. And so that was the only thing that they allowed them to take, the occupiers.
Wow.
And so that what we're seeing here is that the Seattle city government is really trying to go the approachment of appeasement with these occupiers. And as history has shown us, is that appeasement only works short term. And they don't seem to really have a long-term goal in terms of trying to retake this area.
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask. Like, it doesn't seem like the city's in any hurry to remove them. It seems like they're terrified of them.
Yeah, kind of. It's very interesting because the mayor is throwing her full support behind this movement. And here's the thing: the occupiers, they hate the mayor. They gained access to City Hall a few days ago because there was a councilwoman who was very socialist, Councilwoman Shawan. Mm. She had her key to City Hall, so that's how they're able to get in. And when they were inside the lobby, they were chanting for the mayor to resign. So maybe it is because she's terrified, but for some reason she's trying to think, oh, well, if I play nice with them, they'll probably play nice with me. And that's not the case at all. They do not like her.
Yeah, that's not going to happen because they view her as being part of the problem with this. And she's trying to ally herself with them. So what about the businesses that are in that area? Because you had, and I've seen it in your timeline, that there have been businesses who have been texting friends and family, and there have been other businesses who say that I guess it's the Raz squad, the Chazers, I don't know, or the Chazians, Chazers, Chazersizers, I don't even know. It's what one caller suggested, that businesses were being extorted like in a protection racket. What do you know about this?
So I haven't seen any evidence of that. I know the Seattle Police Department said that they have received calls. For me personally, I haven't seen any of that. And in fact, there is a gay nightclub called Cuff that's on the near the outskirts of the one of the barricades, and they were actually helping the occupiers because that kind of became a supply drop off point. So I went inside to see what, and the whole floor was just filled with all these supplies that were donated by the local community.
Wow.
So I don't know if there's any truth to that. I myself haven't seen any evidence for extortion, but yeah, the people are definitely frequenting. They're going to the businesses, and I've seen them, you know, order food and such. But in terms of extortion, I haven't seen any evidence of that.
Well, I'm glad that they're ordering food because I was looking at the photos that you have of their victory garden, where it looked like they just put some topsoil on grass and then bought some plants like halfway into their growing season.
They just put topsoil on cardboard box, on like flattened cardboard boxes. So it's not even dug into the ground. It's the ground, cardboard boxes, and then like that little bit of topsoil on top. So it's not even like a full, it's not even like in the ground per se.
I don't know what to say to that. Oh my gosh. Well, that's not going to feed anybody.
Yeah.
I mean, they're hippies. I would think, some of them are. I would think that they would have a better idea.
Oh, yeah. No. This is what happens when the hippies from Woodstock are taking over the city government, essentially.
Oh, my gosh.
They just let everything.
And the and the demands that they have, because obviously, not this, I guess, that there's no willingness by the mayor or even Jay Inslee. There's no willingness by anybody to actually end any of this. So unless their demands are met, but it's, what are their demands? Because I've seen a huge list of like 30 some odd things. Is that actually the thing that's been circulating online? Are those their demands?
Yes. So those are absolutely their demands. And really, and of course, the very first one and that they have at the top of their list is that they want the complete defunding complete dismantling of the Seattle Police Department. And that just flies in direct contradiction to what national Democrats and members of the mainstream media have been saying the past few weeks about what defunding the police really means. They're saying, oh, it's not really about dismantling departments. It's more about just redirecting some funds. But, you know, obviously, we're still going to have a police force. But no, I can say from, because I was in Minneapolis, I was in Los Angeles recently, and now here, I can say that from being on the ground and seeing what those activists want, the people that are taken to the streets, since George Floyd's unfortunate death, is that they want the police departments to completely go away. That's what they want. And so the national Democrats and mainstream media, I know I repeat myself with that, but I don't know how they're trying to finagle their way out of that. But when they say defund the police, they absolutely mean 100% defund the police.
Man, that's going to be that's going to come to a head, because at some point Democrats are going to have to go on record whether or not they officially support it or not. Even Joe Biden's trying to kind of get away from it by adding caveats to, oh, I don't want to defund the police, but that's going to, oh man, I hope you stay safe. So far, it seems you've been able to stay pretty safe out there and get some really good coverage. So we hope you continue to do so. Godspeed to you, Julio. Everybody needs to follow Julio Rosas right now because he has, I'm still trying to get over the garden thing that you told me. I cannot get over that. It was literally just cardboard put down and then some topsoil. I don't even have words. Julio, God bless you, my friend. Townhall.com. Find him on Twitter. I'll retweet him as well so folks can find him. But Julio_Rosas11. Go and find all of his work. It's awesome. Thank you, my friend. Be safe and Godspeed.